消费者协会宣布将同人民协会合作，为手机应用程序省钱之友招募2000名社区义工。
那这些义工呢，将向邻里居民推广这个应用，并鼓励他们分享优惠和促销活动的信息。
而应用呢，从后天起也将推出新的布告栏功能，让用户分享对商品的点评、促销还有贴士。
物价上涨加重国人生活费压力，消费者协会手机应用省钱之友可帮助国人货比三家，买到价廉物美的商品。也是消费者协会主席的拉丁马市区议员杨义才在国会辩论财政预算案声明时说，当局接下来还将积极招募义工，让更多消费者能受益于这个应用。
CASE will work with the People's Association to recruit 2,000 grassroots volunteersAcross all constituencies as price kaki champions. These volunteers will help to suss out deals within their own neighborhoods and to teach others to use the price kaki app to find the best deals.
有议员建议允许国人使用技能创前程培训补助向企业申请实习岗位，也有议员希望政府在发放就业入息补助给低薪员工的同时，也考量他们的家庭负担。
The WIS should also be recalibrated to take into account household incomes and size. The current WIS is pegged to an individual using the worker's age, employment status and income to determine the disbursement amount.But this supplement is provided even to a lower wage worker in a wealthier household.
I hope that we can consider allowing companies that are able to submit credible proposals for apprenticeship programs to take on trainees that apply with their Skills Future credits. The offset from Skills Future would effectively mean a subsidized worker.
一些议员呼吁政府加大力度照顾包括残障人士、心理健康问题患者等群体的需求，例如为他们提供保险覆盖。
As the Monetary Authority of Singapore prepares to introduce guidelines for financial institutions to embrace fair and responsible practices towards customers in mid-2024, it is imperative that clear directives are established on how rejection.Loading and exclusion criteria should be set for individuals with disabilities, autism, and mental health disorders.
如果医疗人员能够掌握更多关于残障人士的信息，如个人的残疾状况，那么他们可以更好地规划服务体验，为残障人士以及看护提供更好的服务。